Magyana Timirandasya Gyananjana Shalakaya Chakshurunmilitam Ena Tasmai Shri Gurave Namaha Nama Om Vishnu Padhaya Krishna Preshtaya Bhutale Srimate Jayapataka Swaminiti Namine Namacharya Padhaya Nita Krupa Pradayine Gaurakata Dhamadaya Nagara Gramatarine Nama Om Vishnu Padhaya Krishna Preshtaya Bhutale Srimate Bhakti Vedanta Swaminiti Namine Namaste Saraswati Deve Gauravani Pracharine Nirvishesha Shunyavadi Pashyatya Deshatarine Om Namo Bhagavate Vasudevaya Om Namo Bhagavate Vasudevaya Om Namo Bhagavate Vasudevaya Narayanam Namaskritya Naram Chaiva Narottamam Devim Saraswatim Vyasam Tato Jayamudirayet Nashtaprayeshu Abhadreshu Nityam Bhagavata Sevaya Bhagavati Uttama Shloke Bhaktir Bhavati Naistiki. Reading from Srimad Bhagavatam, Canto 1, Chapter Number 14, Text Number 3. Kalasya cha gatim raudhram viparyastattu dharminaha kapiyashim drunam bhartam krodha lobhanrutatmanam. Kalasya cha gatim raudhram viparyastattu dharminaha papiyashim drunam vartam krodha lobhanrutatmanam. Kalasya jagatim raudhram viparyastartu dharminaha papiyashim drunam vartam krodha lobhanrutatmanam. Translation and purport by Stephen Rees, A.C. Bhaktivedanta Swami Srila Prabhupada, Srila Prabhupada ki jai. Translation. He saw that the direction of eternal time had changed, and this was very fearful. There were disruptions in the seasonal regularities. The people in general had become very greedy, angry, and deceitful. And he saw that they were adopting foul means of livelihood. Purport. When civilization is disconnected from the loving relation of the Supreme Personality Godhead, symptoms like changes of seasonal regulations, foul means of livelihood, greed, anger, and fraudulence become rampant. The change of seasonal regulations refers to one season's atmosphere becoming manifest in another season. For example, the rainy seasons being transferred to autumn, or the fructification of fruits and flowers from one season and another season. A godless man is invariably greedy, angry, and fraudulent. Such a man can earn his livelihood by any means, black or white. During the reign of Maharaja Yudhisthira, all the above symptoms were conspicuous by their absence. But Maharaja Yudhisthira was astonished to experience even a slight change in the godly atmosphere of his kingdom, and at once he suspected the disappearance of the Lord. Foul means of livelihood implies deviation from one's occupational duty. There are prescribed duties for everyone, such as the Brahmana, Kshatriya, Vaishya, and Shudra. But anyone who deviates from his prescribed duty and declares another's duty to be his own is following a foul or improper duty. A man becomes too greedy for wealth and power when he has no higher objective in life, and when he thinks that this earthly life of a few years is all in all. Ignorance is the cause for all these anomalies in human society, and to remove this ignorance, especially in this age of degradation, the powerful sun is there to distribute light in the shape of Srimad Bhagavatam. So actually this is a compilation of a book. I have compiled a book. This is called as Spiritual Study. My Spiritual Study, Volume 1. So this book I dedicate to His Divinity Bhaktivedanta Swami Prabhupada and His Holiness Jayapataka Maharaja. This book I have prepared almost 5-6 months back. This is today. Today is 12th of December 2018 at my village. So the chapter number is 16. The chapter name is Foul Means of Livelihood. This book is compiled by me It contains 43 chapters. Volume 1 is ready, volume 2 is ready. But this book is only for educational purpose, academical purpose. So today's chapter number 16, Foul Means of Livelihood. So the shloka is Srimad Bhagavatam 1.14.3. So this is during the end of Dwapara Yuga and the beginning of Kali Yuga. So after winning the battle of Kurukshetra, Yudhishthira ruled the earthly planet as emperor, and so he saw there are certain changes in his kingdom. He saw direction of eternal time had changed, and this was very fearful. So when there is a change of one Kali Yuga, when there is a change cycle of Yuga changes, there is a different lot of changes happens. When Dwapara Yuga was there, it was different. When Kali Yuga started, things are going to be different. So he saw the direction of eternal time had changed. So which means since Dwapara Yuga is ending, so Kali Yuga is going to come out, is going to start. So he saw the changes, and this was very fearful for him. So there were disruptions to the seasonal regularities. So the people in general had become very greedy, angry and deceitful. Disruptions means during rainy season rain will not come. During summer season it will be it may rain or it may be very cold. It may not, sunshine will not come. Sometimes sunshine may not come. Sometimes it may be very heavy rain. So there is no proper season regularities. Summer, winter, it should come on regular cycle. But if it is coming in inter cycles, this is called seasonal irregularities. The people in general had become very greedy. So greedy means, so since they are getting everything, whatever they desire, they are getting. Actually, they have no higher ambitions in life. So because of that, they become too greedy to accumulate more money, more name, fame, popularity. They want dhanam, they want janam, followers, they want money, wealth, and dhanam, follower, dhanam, janam, sundarim. They want the three things. Chaitanya Mahaprabhu said, nadhanam, najanam, nasundari. I don't want anything, wealth, or followers, or women. So, but in Kali Yuga, people will be interested in only these things. They want followers, they want wealth, they want beautiful women. So people have become too greedy. So that is very clearly we can see the so many industries have come out for meat, gambling industries, intoxication industries, illicit industries, prostitution, abortion, contraceptive, so many things is happening. People are very greedy, share market. And this petrol also is kind of greedy, too much greedy. So petrol, diesel, this gas, and the share market, trading, stock exchange, so many insurance, all these things, people are very greedy. And angry and deceitful. Angry, now angry means for small things they fight like anything. They quarrel for property, they quarrel for wealth, they quarrel for women. So they quarrel for these things. As if these three things are going to be, leave them, it is going to give them all kinds of happiness, as if these are going to exist with them for eternality. So you may be taken birth in a particular country, you are going to live for some time and you go die. But too much attachment to a particular country and you oppose, you become enemy of some other country. And you spend your entire lifetime opposing them, defending from the country. So too much enviousness of other countries. People are greedy, angry, deceitful. Deceitful means you are not qualified for a particular thing, but you pose as if you are extremely qualified for that. Suppose you are not a doctor, but you act like a doctor. This is called deceit. You are not qualified to be a doctor, but you act like a doctor. This is called deceit. So you are not a brahmana, but you act like a brahmana. So this is called deceit. So people have become deceitful. And he saw that they were adopting foul means of livelihood. So foul means of livelihood means they claim themselves as Brahmana, Kshatriya, Vaishya, Shudra, but they don't act according to that. So Brahmana means you should educate others, but nowadays Brahmanas are not educating others. They are engaging in any skill technicians. They are acting as a technician, as acting as a laborer, acting as a workman. They are not acting as a teacher. Brahmana means they should teach others, they should perform sacrifice, they should perform a penance, austerity. But nowadays they are not performing the brahminical duties. They are performing, they are taking the profession of Brahmana, are taking the profession of Kshatriya, the Brahmanas are taking the profession of Vaishyas, Brahmanas are taking the profession of Shudras. So they are gliding down themselves. And even Kshatriyas are not acting like Kshatriyas. Now they are working like Shudras. And Vaishyas are not acting like Vaishyas. They are working like Shudras. So they are not producing cows. They are not protecting cows. They are only selling the cows to slaughter houses. And Vaishyas, they are not producing grains also. Too much greedy. They are selling. If they are exporting, most of the people, they are exporting to other countries, other states. Vaishyas. Kshatriyas, instead of protecting the citizens, they are allowing meat-eating industries, gambling industries, intoxication industries, illicit industries. So, Kshatriyas, instead of protecting the citizens, they are allowing the citizens to be spoiled or exploited by criminals, exploited by all kinds of sinful activities. The government allows, Kshatriyas are allowing all kinds of sinful activities to be spread everywhere, rampant. Kshatriyas should protect people from this all kinds of sinful activities, irreligious things. But Kshatriyas, because they themselves are religious and people also irreligious, so there is no protection by the Kshatriyas. So Kshatriyas are not able to act like Kshatriyas. So they are just getting the salary from the government and just ruling the citizens. Or just sake of showcasing as they are ruling. So they are not protecting the citizens. Brahmanas are not educating. Kshatriyas are not protecting. Vaishyas are not protecting the cows. Kshatriyas are not protecting the citizens. Brahmanas are not protecting the Vedas. Brahmanas are not protecting the religion. No, they are not spreading. Kshatriyas are not protecting the lives of the citizens. Vaishyas are not protecting the cows. They are sending the cows to slaughter houses. Shudras are not serving the Brahmanas. Instead, Shudras want to be served by Brahmanas. So because Shudras are ruling the government, Shudras are ruling all of us, so they want to be served by Brahmanas. And he saw that they were adopting foul means of livelihood. Foul means of livelihood means, as I already told you, this Kshatriyas are acting like Shudras, Vaishyas are acting like Shudras. They are also acting like Shudras. They have no knowledge. Simply government gives them some sanction of loan, they are working, that's all. They are not performing sacrifices, people are not performing sacrifices. When civilization is disconnected from the loving relationship of the Supreme Personality Godhead, symptoms like changes of seasonal regulations, foul means of livelihood, greed, anger and fraudulence become rampant. So when people have no higher ambitions in life, So every jivara sorupa hoy nityare Krishna das. All the living entities are considered to be servant of Lord Krishna. When the servants are not engaged in the service of the master, they themselves want to enjoy all everything. They want to enjoy the property of the master. So that is what is happening. Because the living entities, they are servant of God. They are not engaged in the service of God. They are disconnected from the loving relationship of Supreme. Because they are disconnected from the loving relationship of the Supreme Person, the Godhead, symptoms like changes of seasonal regulations, foul means of livelihood, greed, anger and fraudulence become rampant. So as Prabhupada has mentioned in purport, so these things are rampant. Greed, anger, fraudulence has become rampant. Foul means of livelihood. The change of seasonal regulations refers to one season's atmosphere becoming manifest in another season. For example, the rainy seasons being transferred to autumn, or the fructification of fruits and flowers from one season in another season. Nowadays, these fruits and flowers also is like people are coming out with a lot of technology, biotechnology. So many brinjal, so many mustard seeds, so many fruits, flowers, grains, everything is by, you know, genetically modified crops, genetically modified organisms. This is what is happening nowadays by technology. They want to become God. These technical people, they want to become God because God has created all these things. And since these people are destroying all these things, now they want to create on their own. And that is, they take patent for that. They want copyright for that. So you cannot have the grains, you cannot store the seeds. You have to buy the seeds every time from them. So it is totally an exploitation of everything is being exploited. We are being exploited by this demonic people. They are called technicians, these technologists, biotechnologists especially. Genetic engineering, biotechnology, this is all totally cheating. Defying the creation of God. A godless man is invariably greedy, angry and fraudulent because everything belongs to God. So the godless man, he doesn't believe in the existence of God. So he thinks everything belongs to him. So that's why he becomes too greedy. If someone thinks that this not belongs to me, this belongs to God, then he will not be greedy. So because he thinks there is no God, then he thinks everything belongs to me. So he becomes greedy, angry and fraudulent. Such a man can earn his livelihood by any means, black or white. So that's why we see nowadays it is said that these politicians are holding, hiding the black money or money in Switzerland banks. So all the black money is there in Switzerland banks. So a lot of things, corruption is happening. We all eat only 2 times a day, 3 times a day. And that too with little, we have a little tongue, little belly. So we are not like animals like that. No, cow, animals like elephant to eat voraciously. We have very little tongue, mouth and belly. So we can eat very little only. But the people, because they are too much greedy, they accumulate money as if they are going to eat unlimited foodstuff, as if they are going to live unlimited lifetime. They are not going to live more than 50, 60 years, but they are accumulating money for 300 years, 400 years. So these things were not present during the period of Maharaja Yudhishthira, because Maharaja Yudhishthira is a religious personified. He is a son of Dharmaraj. So because of that, Lord Krishna wanted Dharmaraja to become the ruler of the earthly planet. Duryodhana is a disciple of Kali. So Dharmaraja is son of Yudhishthira Maharaj, is son of Dharmaraj. So Lord Krishna wanted Dharmaraja to rule the planet. So during the reign of Maharaja Yudhishthira, all the above symptoms were conspicuous by their absence. So these were not visible during the Maharaja's period. So but Maharaja Yudhishthira was astonished to experience even a slight change in the godly atmosphere of his kingdom. And at once he suspected the disappearance of the Lord. So such things were not present during the reign of some pious rulers. As soon as such impious things started to manifest, the rulers become very fearful. The rulers started feeling astonished. So because of Lord Krishna has left this earthly planet, the dharma also has left. Foul means of livelihood implies deviation from one's occupational duty. There are prescribed duties for everyone, such as the Brahmana, Kshatriya, Vaishya and Shudra. But anyone who deviates from his prescribed duty and declares another's duty to be his own is following a foul and improper duty. So there are three modes of material nature, Sattvaguna, Rajaguna, Tamaguna. As per our association with these three modes of nature, Sattvaguna, Rajaguna, Tamaguna. So if you are in Sattvaguna, we should act like a Brahmana. If we are in Rajaguna, we should act like a Kshatriya. If we are in Rajaguna, Tamaguna, we act like a Vaishyas. If we are in Tamaguna, we act like a Shudras. So, as per the modes of material nature we are associating, we are being given a particular body. So, as per the body, we have to act. If you are in Sattvaguna, we should act like a Brahmana. If you are in Rajaguna, we should act like a Kshatriya. If you are Tamaguna, Rajaguna, we should act like a Vaishya. If you are in Tamaguna, we should act like a Shudra. So, we should not jump to other order. Vaishyas should not become like Shudras, or Vaishyas should not jump to try to become like Kshatriyas, Vaishyas should not try to become like Brahmanas, and Brahmanas should not degrade themselves to Vaishyas, Brahmanas should not degrade themselves to Kshatriyas, they should not degrade themselves to Shudras. This is called foul means of livelihood. So deviation from one's occupational duty. So Brahmana means he should study, he should make others study, he should educate others. First of all, he should learn and he should educate others. This is Brahmana. So if there are prescribed duties for everyone, such as the Brahmana, Kshatriya, Vaishya, Shudra, but anyone who deviates from his prescribed duty and declares another's duty to be his own is following a foul and improper duty. So if somebody is following this improper, foul means of livelihood, then is irreligious. Is following a foul and improper duty. So it is a dharma of Brahmanas to educate, it's a dharma of Kshatriyas to protect, it's a dharma of Vaishyas to protect cows, it is a dharma of Shudras to serve. So everybody has to follow their own dharma, that is called Varnashrama dharma. So now people are not following this Varnashrama dharma, all other Varna, there is a mixture of dharma. So-called Brahmanas, they are working like Shudra. So-called Brahmanas working like Vaishyas. Now Vaishyas are acting like Brahmanas. Now they see so many share market, they are giving all lectures, thousands of, so many things are happening. So many discussions going on in the web, the television, media, so many discussions going on. But without referring to scriptures, Shastras, they are speaking. A man becomes too greedy for wealth and power when he has no higher objective in life. So if someone thinks that this body is temporary, we all have to serve Lord Krishna and we have to go to spiritual world where everything is permanent. In this world is temporary. If someone has someone has higher ambitions to serve Lord Krishna out of love and serve the Lord Krishna, the Supreme Person, the Godhead, he will not be greedy, he will not be of wealth and power, because everything in Lord Krishna himself says in Bhagavad Gita, this world is Dukkhalayam and Asashvatam. This material world is from topmost planet Brahmaloka to Patala Loka, everywhere the same things, birth, death, old age, disease, everything is there. So Lord Krishna himself declared that this world is a Dukkhalayam and Asashvatam, temporary and full of miseries. So why it is people should be interested in such things, that to accumulate wealth and power, why should people interested in such things, wealth and power? Because it is temporary, everything is temporary and full of miseries also. Why should they be interested? Because on account of godlessness, they have no, because they are not having the knowledge of God, they are not having the knowledge of soul, they are not having the knowledge of the Atma and Paramatma, Lord Krishna. So because of ignorance, they think that they are everything. There is no God. I am everything. Because of that, they become too greedy and they are after wealth and power. Earthly life of few years is all in all. A human form of life is very insignificant. We don't live more than 50, 60 years. There are higher species like Yaksha, Rakshasas, Vidyadhara, Charana, Devatas, Siddhas, so many Gandharvas, so many Siddha, Brahma, demigods, Indra, Chandra, Varuna, Vayu, so many 33 crore demigods are there, different categories of living entities are there, and then Sadashiva, Brahma, and then Vaikuntha Loka and Koloka, so many planets are there. So this earthly life is very insignificant, flash, not even this insignificant life. In our eternal journey, this life is nothing. But people, they think this is everything, and they spend all their lifetimes, time and energy for accumulating money, power, which is temporary. So ignorance is the cause for all these anomalies in human society, and to remove this ignorance, especially in this age of degradation, the powerful sun is there to distribute light in the shape of Srimad Bhagavatam. So that planet Rahu, it always covers all of us. Now when the solar eclipse occurs, lunar eclipse occurs, this planet Rahu covers an entire the world becomes full of darkness. Darkness means ignorance. Ignorance means darkness. So because sunshine is not present, everywhere darkness is pervading. Similarly, in Kali Yuga, because of the influence of these planets, Rahu, Ketu, and especially Rahu planet, because of the influence of Rahu planet, and people have become very ignorant. So because of ignorance, people are acting foolishly. They are becoming atheistic. They are becoming godless. So in order to overcome from the influence of these stars, they should worship Lord Krishna, Lord Vishnu. They should chant the holy name of Lord Krishna. Ignorance is the cause for all these anomalies in society, and to remove this ignorance, especially in this age of degradation, the powerful sun is there to distribute light in the shape of Srimad Bhagavatam. So Srimad Bhagavata Puranam is a powerful sun which can dissipate the darkness pervading this entire world. So Srimad Bhagavatam is none other than, it's a literary incarnation of Lord Krishna. Lord Krishna is manifest in Kali Yuga as Srimad Bhagavata Puranam. So if we have to be wherever there is Krishna, there cannot be any darkness. Krishna Surya Samam Maya Hoy Andhakar. Krishna is like sunshine, Maya is darkness. Wherever there is Krishna, there cannot be Maya. So we should read Bhagavatam daily, you know, and serve Lord Krishna, serve Vaishnavas. And we have to distribute these books, we have to distribute Srila Prabhupada's teachings to others. So let the darkness of this world be removed. Let the sunshine, the powerful sunshine, let the Krishna come in our life as powerful sun. Let it brighten all of us. Let the darkness of Rahu go away from our life. Let this sunshine of Lord Krishna come into our life. Thank you very much. Hare Krishna. Gurantara Srimad Bhagavatam ki jai, Srila Prabhupada ki jai, Guru Maharaj ki jai, Ananta Koti Vaishnava Vrinda ki jai.